Hi everyone, welcome back to another video. Today's video is a figure review. Sorry I have not been doing a video lately. A week or two ago I had the flu, I was sick, so I did not feel like doing any videos. Not having a camera unmotivates me to do videos every day. When I had a camera before it broke, it was easier to do a video, and I can do videos on my phone too, but I have to upload them in parts or cut the videos, and I don't like doing that unless I absolutely have to, and with that I do. And then as you guys know, I'm getting ready to move, only like an hour away to where my best friends live, and most of my stuff is packed up, so I don't have a lot of video ideas. So yeah, I'm getting ready to move. Luckily, I think my sister will be in this house throughout the summer. My family address will eventually be removed, but there will be a video about that soon. So if you have any fan mail videos, let me know. I love doing those videos, but it's up to you guys to keep those videos going. And if you want to see more, you can send fan mail. Remember, it doesn't always have to be a toy or something. It can be a letter, a picture, and I'll do a fan mail video or something. So today's review, when I was packing, I noticed something I had that was hanging up on the wall or door, actually, and it was coming out of the packaging, and it's from the TV show Lost, and it is my 8-inch Juliet figure. I love the show Lost. I did not watch it when it was on air. I'm kind of glad because that show had really bad cliffhangers. Not bad, it sucked, but it made you want more, obviously. The cliffhangers were crazy on that show. So I'm glad it's on Netflix. There's 6 seasons, and I'm glad I can watch all the way through now. And I've seen that show about 3-4 times now, all the way through. Sometimes I go back and just watch a couple episodes here, or sometimes I'll go back and I will watch the show from the beginning to end. I do that with almost every show I've seen, like Once Upon a Time, Lost, Prison Break, whatever, you name it, Walking Dead. What's cool is Eddie and Adam, who are the creators of Once Upon a Time, are from Lost. They were writers on Lost, and a lot of the cast from Once Upon a Time has been on Lost, like Elizabeth Mitchell here, who played Juliet, she was the Snow Queen in Lost. Emily DeRaven, who played Claire in Lost, was Belle in Once Upon a Time. And then Hurley was the giant on Once Upon a Time. So that's pretty cool. I think it would be cool if they came out with like Once Upon a Time versions of these. So, as I did say, was coming off her card. I had her carded. What I think I'm going to do next, after I'm done with this video, is glue it back on, because I like her in the box. But let's take a look at the packaging. So we have right there the Lost logo. It says officially licensed product. It says collect all 8-inch action figures. They're kind of like dolls, and this is in right there. I'm gonna have to. It says Juliet Burke, Series 4, and then under each name, it has what group they were, and Juliet was a part of the others at first. And this video will contain spoilers, so if you haven't seen Lost, go back, watch Lost, and then watch the review. And, so I have 3 favorite characters, Kate, Jack, and Juliet here. Juliet took some time for me to grow on her. I wasn't a big fan of her at first just because of her actions, but when you learn her story and her backstory and her motivations, and when she, joins, Jack's group, I really started to love her. And then when Sawyer and her ended up together, I thought they were perfect together, as I did with Kate and Jack, and then I kind of fell in love with the character. This is the only one I have. I really want to get, actually all of these, but I want to get Jack and Kate the most. This is some of the ones in this series, and there's some more. On the back, we have Sawyer, and he's part of the Dharma Initiative. We have Jack, he's part of the Oceanic Six. Juliet, of course. Saeed, he is a part of the Beach. Maelstrom is a part of the Freighter Folk. And then Claire is a part of the Cave. And then if we turn the back over, there's another Lots logo. And then there's a read-up, which I will read. It says, somewhere over the Pacific Ocean, a plane crashes on a seemingly deserted island. 48 survivors with little hope of rescue. The passengers of the ill-fated Oceanic Airlines Flight 815 didn't know, but they would be tested to their absolute limits. Each boarded the plane with hope of somehow escaping their troubled lives, only to find themselves in a strange place beyond their wild imaginations. Stranded in the middle of nowhere, these strangers have to find a way to live together or surely die alone. So that's a great read up. Lost can be confusing sometimes. I know when I first watched the show, I had a lot of questions and very little answers. So on the back, there are more figures in this series, as you can see, and I'll just go ahead and name them. We have Benjamin Linus, Kate Austin, Hugo Hurley Reyes, John Locke, Jacob Manon Black, Miles, Claire, Saeed, Jax Shepherd, Juliet Burke, and James Sawyer Ford. And I would love to have all of these, actually, but of course I would want Kate right there, and then I would want Jack next. And I'm not sure why I didn't get them. I'm not sure why I got her first. So this is pretty nice packaging. Then we have, I think these were at Comic-Con. These came out in 2011, actually a year after the show ended. I think 2010, either 2009 or 10. And there's the ABC logo. And I think it would be cool if, since ABC is owned by Disney, and since Once Upon a Time the show was Disney, and technically Lost is Disney, if like Disney parks, like Disney World or Disneyland, had like a section where you can go, like, and there's like Lost rides and people are dressed up as Lost characters, same with Once Upon a Time, that would be very cool. So as I said, I'm not gonna even pause to open it because it's already open, and all I have to do is slide her out and take her off her plastic, which I will be keeping. So this is a pretty cool figure. We'll go ahead and start with her articulation. Now she has kind of a doll-like body, and she has this very standard swivel head, hinged shoulders, hinged elbows, hinged wrists, jointed torso, hinged hips, hinged knees, and hinged ankles. So lots of articulation. You can get her into some pretty cool poses. And this is the outfit she wore when, I think in season 5, maybe at the end of, maybe in season 4, one of them, I'm pretty sure season 5 though, she wore when she was, I think, washing dishes, when her and Sora and some of the other group were sent back in time to the 70s when the Dharma Initiative were around, and they kind of didn't know how to get back to their time, so they just stayed there. And Sawyer and Juliet were together. And there's a scene, I think it's in the first episode of season 5, where she's washing dishes or she's making dinner or something, and Sawyer and her live together, and he comes and she turns around and he has a flower for her, and she's smiling, and they're all in love and happy. And like I said, I wasn't a huge fan of her at first because I thought she was a bad person, and you learn she's really not a bad person. She just kind of does whatever she can to survive, you know. So the clothes are soft goods. As you can see there around her kind of neck, she has flower designs, embroidery right there. And also, she has on the arms as well, both sides. And then she does have just jeans, nicely stitched jeans on. And then she does have brown shoes on with sculpted shoelaces there and stuff. And the shoes can come off. It takes a little force though. Lost is a very strange show, actually. It's if you're sorry, I had to kind of force it. If you're looking for kind of a creative show, a kind of a mystery, sci-fi, not knowing what's gonna happen, Nos is definitely a show for you. This other shoe. Anyway, I'm not gonna force it if it doesn't want to come off, but there's what the shoe looks like off. And it's just a brown shoe sculpted. They're in a jungle on an island, so they're not gonna be wearing heels or sandals that much. But there's her barefoot. And it's just a standard doll body. And you can take off the clothes. And I'm only going to take off the jeans just for review purposes to show you. So there is in the back, in the front, a Velcro, kind of like with dolls, they have Velcro, and it's in the front, kind of like real jeans, except we don't have Velcro. We have buttons and stuff like that. So here it are the jeans. And you can change them like to make like maybe another outfit that she wore on the show, or like the pink shirt she had on, I think when she died. But here's the jeans. And I'm not going to take the shirt off just because of the hair. It's sculpted and it's a little hard to get off, but there's the body. And I'm guessing the other females in this line, like Kate and maybe Claire, have the same body as well. And if you wanted to, since Elizabeth Mitchell played Ingrid, aka the Snow Queen, on Once Upon a Time, you could make a custom Snow Queen figure out of this. You probably would have to be really good at like sewing and stuff like that. I'm not, so she's gonna stay Juliet, but that would be really cool if you did make a Snow Queen figure out of this figure. And you can make like with the Claire figure in this series, you can make her Belle, even though she has blonde hair, you still can paint over and stuff. So I thought that was pretty cool. They kind of gave you, I know some customizers out there that would like that. I mainly know Walking Dead customizers, but that's just me. Now these pants are giving me a little hard time with putting them back on. I don't think you're supposed to take them off, but you can. There we are. But she's gonna stay in this outfit, obviously. I don't know how to sew, but you could make other outfits if you wanted that she wore in the show, because she wore a couple different ones. Other parts of the figure is the hair. I think it's nicely sculpted. I think it's just the right color how Juliet had in the show. Nicely sculpted. You can see the waves, and you can see kind of there's different like shades in it. It's better to see in person, but there's different shades and stuff in it of blonde, and I think that's really cool. And then we get to the face sculpt, and I think the face sculpt does resemble Juliet Elizabeth Mitchell. I think they could have done a little better. I think with any action figure company or company that makes action figures, sometimes they have a problem with female sculpts. Sometimes they don't really get the female sculpts that look to look like the actors. Sometimes they really get it on, and then sometimes it's in the middle. And I think this is in the middle. I think it definitely does look like her. And if you've seen the show, obviously, but if you walked past the shelf and she was standing on the shelf, you would probably know it's Juliet. She can stand. I'm just gonna show you. She can stand. If you wanted to make her stand, she can. So I think that's pretty cool. Unfortunately, she does not come with any accessories, and she couldn't hold them anyway because both of her hands are opened, as you can see. But you know what I do when a figure is like that and I want them to hold a weapon or something, and I just use blue sticky tack. Yeah, the tack can show sometimes, but hey, at least it works, and maybe you can put a gun in there or something, or a flower that Sawyer gives her. And you can get her in cool poses, you know, she has a lot of articulation. I like this figure a lot. I do recommend the show Lost. I thought it was really good. And, let me know if you've seen the show Lost and who are your favorite characters. I love Jack, Kate, and Juliet the most, but I liked Sawyer, I like John Locke, I liked Ben, but those were my favorites. And these are pretty cool figures, and I would love to get all of them. They're pretty cheap. I got her for pretty cheap, too. But this is the rest that I showed you. And let me know if you have any of these figures, and what your thoughts are on them. And if you haven't seen Lost, definitely go watch it. It's a great show, as I said. All 6 seasons are on Netflix. And I hope to get more of these down the road. Let me know what you think of this, and let me know what you think of the character of Juliet. Did you like her? Did you not like her? It started off as not liking her, but then at the end, I really did like her. So thank you for watching. And all my information is down below. My fan mail address is there still for now. I'm not sure how much longer it will be there. So if you have any fan mail address, mail, it's not required, but if you want to see more videos, it's up to you guys to keep those videos going. And it doesn't have to be a toy or a Pop Funko. It can be a letter, it can be a drawing. I like homemade stuff a lot, and I'm hoping Pop Funko releases another line of Lost Pops, because they did, but Juliet wasn't in them. Funko, you need to release another line of Lost and put Juliet in them, and like Ben, and like other characters, because I need a Juliet pop. So that's gonna do it for this video. All my information, as always, is down below. Let me know what you think of the figure, and until next time, have a great day. Bye. Okay, you guys made it to the end of the video. Thank you for watching. I hope you guys enjoyed the video. Remember, you guys can follow me on the social media links I have in my channel and down below. And I also do have a fan mail address. If you would like to send fan mail, feel free to do so. And I hope you guys enjoyed this review. Please subscribe to my channel and have a great day. Bye.